to the AYTM.com Advanced MaxDiff tutorial video. In this video, I will show you how to get the best results if you need to determine the rank of a very long list of ideas, names, or slogans you are considering, in the order of preference by your target audience. This is best used when your list can't be squeezed into a smaller ranking question type. You will learn how to avoid order and combination bias, reduce the cognitive toll on respondents by asking bite-sized questions, achieve the greatest efficiency without programming a survey map, and how to read the results on our stats page in any way you want without waiting for complex outputs from a statistician. MaxDiff, or maximum difference scaling, is a discrete choice model first described by Jordan Louviere in 1987. The Advanced MaxDiff test is a great way to compare many alternatives without overwhelming respondents by asking them to read and consider all items at once. It takes a list of your items to be compared, automatically generates a few questions within the experiment, and shows your items in a balanced order to each respondent, four at a time. Each item will be shown at least twice to each respondent. When sufficient data are collected, we'll complete the advanced statistical analysis on the back end and show you the hierarchy of how respondents ranked your alternatives, as well as the distance between each item. Using this technology, you can also find out which attributes of a brand or features of your product are most important to consumers. The Advanced MaxDiff test is more accurate than the classical MaxDiff test because it uses adaptive real-time randomization that works while the survey is being fulfilled to provide the greatest possible efficiency of item distribution per question and per respondent, rather than relying on a pre-programmed map of the entire test. Why does this matter? Two reasons. One, you don't have to wait a few days for a statistician to design and program an efficiency map for you. And two, efficiency will be monitored and corrected automatically with every survey complete, so even if some respondents decide to take a break and maybe walk their dog or eat a sandwich without finishing your survey, we'll make corresponding alterations to the other combinations we serve to other respondents in order to maintain the best efficiency possible. It is also much more user-friendly than classic symmetrical tables used in the past. Instead of asking respondents to hunt down an item on a grid and put a checkbox in the correct column, we present them with four items at a time, also known as a quad, and ask them to rank order the items using our drag-and-drop interface. It conserves respondents' energy and focuses their attention on identifying the winner and loser for each quad with minimal effort. It wouldn't be fair if we made it easy on respondents yet difficult on you. Let me show you how amazingly easy it is to set up something as robust as Advanced MaxDiff on our platform. See this icon in the sidebar? You take all your strength, grab it with your mouse, and drag it to the editor. Not too bad, right? Actually, that's all the heavy lifting we ask you to do. Now just copy and paste your list of alternatives in the first field, and we'll neatly place each into its own field, adding new fields as needed. You can add up to 40 alternatives. Your question text will be repeated for each quad. We recommend including a short instruction such as, "Please rank the following items in the order of your preference, from the most preferred on top to the least preferred on the bottom." The Advanced MaxDiff test is quite sensitive to the number of completes, so we recommend ordering 400 to over 700 responses for 7 to 10 tested items, and we require at least 700 responses for 11 to 40 tested items. We'll show you smart warnings which are relevant to your current sample size and number of alternatives to help you prevent collecting statistically unreliable results. While MaxDiff appears as a single question in the survey editor, it'll take up to 20 separate questions from the respondent's point of view. Please pay attention to the note at the bottom of the question. Experiment is using X number of questions to keep an eye on the length of the survey. You may have to remove some other questions in order to run a larger MaxDiff experiment. Please also keep in mind that even though each question is super easy to complete, it's still quite a tedious process to repeat it with new combinations 20 times in a row. Be considerate of your respondents and limit the number of tested alternatives only to the choices you'd be willing to accept if they rise to the top of the rankings. You may have noticed in the editor that there are no anchors on the right. That's because the order in which compared items are presented in each quad for each respondent cannot be anchored, since it's governed by our special adaptive efficiency algorithm. Each field has a limited number of characters, 120 for questions, 90 for tested items. AYTM Prime members can use up to 240 characters for the question field. If you struggle to fit your text into the character limits, it might be an indication that MaxDiff is not quite the best solution for your needs. If this is an issue for you, you may want to consider presenting each alternative in an instructional text field and setting up a monadic survey design instead of a MaxDiff, where each respondent is only exposed to one alternative and asked to rate it. There is a little loophole to fit longer texts into MaxDiff tests. You can do this by adding longer texts as images. As for any other fields, you can add images here by clicking the camera icon and choosing a photo from your computer. These images can be expanded to the full width of the survey widget or appear as a thumbnail and pop up on mouse rollover as a reference. Use images wisely, since dragging an answer choice with a large image might be cumbersome to respondents, especially on mobile devices. Consider using the side-by-side question type if images are essential to your test. You can learn more about it in the question type section of our site. Please note, we consider breaking your list of items into quads as the best ratio between the length of the survey and easiness of each question. While it's the only way you can run MaxDiff on the platform in DIY, some researchers are used to breaking the list into groups of 3 or 5. If it's critical for you to present 3 or 5 alternatives at a time, please reach out and we'll set it up for you on the back end. MaxDiff questions can have a single skip logic destination. Use the rabbit icon to set it up. Let's now take a look at the stats page. Due to the large number of alternatives usually used in MaxDiff, we present the results as a bar chart, sorted in the order of importance to respondents. At first glance, you can easily identify the winning alternatives and see if there are groups of similarly rated items with a big gap until the next best rated alternative. Check the distances between and among items to better understand their relative importance. Results of the Advanced MaxDiff experiment can be viewed in 3 different ways that you can choose from this combo box. For MaxDiff scale percents, even though respondents only compare a small subset of all alternatives in any given set, the MaxDiff analysis uses these to generate an importance or preference score ranging from 0 to 100 for each alternative. The scores always add up to 100. The higher the score, the more importance consumers place on that particular feature. For average probabilities, each alternative has an average probability that a respondent would rank that item higher than another random alternative. For raw coefficients, in this situation, there is always one attribute that is set to 0, and all other attributes are scored relative to that attribute. From that point of view, comparisons between other attributes can be analyzed as ratio data. For example, if one alternative has a score of 10, another alternative has a score of 5, and a third alternative has a score of 0, one can say that the first alternative is twice as important as the second alternative when compared to the third alternative. Probably the most amazing thing about Advanced MaxDiff and other research tests that you can run on the AYTM platform, besides being great interactive visualizations and easy to use, is that they're fully integrated into your stats page. This means that you can apply any combination of filters by demographics or traits and have the numbers recrunched in almost real time for you. You can see, for example, how preferences for soft drinks varied between genders or among age groups. You could even select a subset of respondents, such as those who are most loyal to a particular brand, and view their answers separately from the others. Traditionally, when you order a MaxDiff test with other research firms, you're limited to a set of particular segments you want it to be analyzed by, and each new cut requires additional time and money. The flexibility that our Advanced MaxDiff gives you is unprecedented, since you can slice and dice the data immediately, however you want it, and at no additional cost per filter or banner. If your filters shrink the sample below statistical relevance, we'll show you a warning so that you never draw unreliable conclusions from your test results. To summarize, our proprietary Advanced MaxDiff is a beautiful turnkey research solution that can save you tens of thousands of dollars and weeks of time. It allows you to compare long lists of items in a very precise, scientific, and sophisticated way without any heavy lifting on your part whatsoever. Sounds too good to be true? Well, technology often does when it replaces outdated methods. Try it for yourself and enjoy the AYTM experience firsthand. That's it for now. Thanks again for watching, and feel free to ping us with questions or to set up a personal demo.